Kita dipakai untuk mengikuti salib kita dan mengikuti dia. Untuk kami dengan tenda berkata seribu bayaran. Bagi mereka semuanya itu adalah tanda kebinasaan, tetapi bagi kamu tanda keselamatan, dan itu datangnya dari Allah. Sebab kepada kamu dikaruniakan bukan saja untuk percaya kepada Kristus, melainkan juga untuk menderita untuk Dia.
Semua
Arms and hands that were always extended in love.
Thank you.
Yusuf dan yang telah menjadi murid Yesus. Dia pergi kepada Pilatus dan meminta jenazah Yesus. Pilatus memberikan perintah untuk jenazah Yesus diberikan kepada Yusuf. Mengambil jenazah Yesus, dibungkusnya dalam kain kafan besi dan diletakkannya di dalam kubur yang baru, yang mana namanya telah terpahat di atas batu. Dan beliau membawa semua batu besar, menutup pintu kubur itu dan berlalu.
Yeah. The church in Western Spain, the fully participate in the passion and death of our Savior, and to be resurrected from the darkness of sin. Our service this evening will begin with first the liturgy of the word, in which the meaning of Christ's death on the cross is explained to us. The second, the veneration of the cross. Through this direct action and gesture, we embrace our Savior in the greatest act of love for us. In the third, Holy Communion, we become one with the body given up for us and the blood shed for all. Let's all take part in this service with faith and devotion in our hearts.
Thank you.
my servant will prosper. He shall be lifted up, exalted, rise great heights. As the crowds were all seeing him, so his spirit did he look. Let him see no longer human. So will the crowds be astonished at him, and kings stand speechless before him. For they shall see something never told, and witness something never heard before. Who could believe what we have heard? And to whom has the power of the Lord been revealed? Like a sapling, he grew up in front of us. Like a root in a red ground. Without beauty, without majesty, we saw him. No looks to attract our eyes. A thing despised and rejected by men. A man of sorrows and familiar with suffering. A man to make people screen their faces. He was despised, and we took no account of him. And yet, ours were the sufferings he bore. Ours the sorrows he carried. But we thought of him as someone punished, struck by God, and brought low. Yet he was pierced for our faults, crushed for our sins. On him lies a punishment that brings us peace. And through his wounds we are healed. We have all gone astray like sheep. Taking his own way, and the Lord burdened him with the sins of all of us. Harshly dealt with, he bore it calmly. He never opened his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughterhouse, like a sheep that is dumb before its shearers, never opening its mouth. By force and by law he was taken. Would anyone plead his cause? Yes, he was torn away from the land of the living. For our faults, struck down in death, they gave him a grave with the wicked. A tomb with the rich. Though he had done no wrong, and there had been no perjury in his mouth, the Lord has been pleased to crush him with suffering. If he offers his life in atonement, he shall see his heirs. He shall have a long life, and what the Lord wishes will be done. His soul's anguish over, he shall see the light and be content. By his sufferings shall my servant justify many, taking the faults on himself. Hence, I will grant shall divide the spoil with the mighty, for surrendering himself to death, and letting himself be taken for a sinner. While he was bearing the faults of many, and maka baiklah kita tekun berpegang pada pengakuan iman kita. Sebab iman agung yang kita punya bukanlah iman agung yang tidak dapat turut merasakan kelemahan kita. Sebaliknya, ia sama dengan kita. Ia telah dicobai, hanya saja tidak berbuat dosa. Sebab itu, marilah kita menghampiri tahta kerahiman Allah dengan penuh keberanian, supaya kita menerima rahmat dan menemukan kasih karunia untuk mendapat pertolongan pada waktunya. Dalam hidupnya sebagai manusia, Yesus telah persembahkan doa dan permohonan dengan rata manis dan keluhan kepada Dia yang sanggup menyelamatkannya dari maut, dan karena kesalehannya ia telah didengarkan. Akan tetapi, sekalipun anak, ia telah belajar menjadi taat. Ini ternyata dari apa yang telah diberitanya, dan sesudah mencapai kesempurnaan, ia menjadi pokok keselamatan abadi bagi semua orang yang taat kepadanya. Demikianlah sabda Tuhan.
Thank you. few of the words he has spoken, not one of those who gave me my Bibles. Simon Peter, who carried a sword, drew it and wounded the high priest's servant, cutting off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter,
"Put your sword back in its scabbard. I want you to drink the cup that the Father has given me."
The cohort and his captain and the Jewish guards seized Jesus and bound him. They took him first to Annas, because Annas was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was high priest that year. He was Caiaphas who had suggested to the Jews, "It is better for one man to die for a people." Simon Peter, with another disciple, followed Jesus. This disciple, who was known to the high priest, went with Jesus into the high priest's palace, but Peter stayed outside the door. So the other disciple, the one known to the high priest, went up, spoke to the woman who was keeping the door, and brought Peter in. The maid on duty at the door said to Peter,
"I too am one of the man's disciples."
He answered,
"I am not."
Now it was cold, and the servants and guards had lit a charcoal fire, and were standing there warming themselves. So Peter stood there too, warming himself with the others. The high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching. Jesus answered,
"I have spoken only for all the world to hear. I have always taught in the synagogue and the temple, where all Jews meet together. I have said nothing in secret. But why? Ask me. Ask my peers what I thought. They know what I said."
At these words, one of the guards standing by gave Jesus a slap in the face, saying,
"Is that the way to answer the high priest?"
Jesus replied,
"If there is something wrong with what I said, point it out. But if there is no offense in it, why do you strike me?"
Then Annas sent him, still up to Caiaphas, the high priest. As Simon Peter stood there for himself, someone said to him,
"Aren't you a brother or a disciple?"
He denied it, saying, a relation of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, said,
"You did not hear it without hearing him."
Again, Peter denied it, and once the cock crew, he then led Jesus from the house of Caiaphas to the praetorium. It was now morning. They did not go into the praetorium themselves, for they would be devout and unable to eat the Passover. So Pilate came outside to them and said,
"What charge do you bring against this man?"
They replied,
"If he were not a criminal, we should not be handing him over to you."
Pilate said,
"Take him yourselves and try him by your own law."
The Jews answered,
"We are not allowed to put a hand to death."
This was to fulfill the words Jesus had spoken, indicating the way he was going to die. So Pilate went back into the praetorium and called Jesus to him, and asked,
"Are you the king of the Jews?"
Jesus replied,
"Do you ask this of your own accord, or have others spoken to you about me?"
Pilate answered,
"Am I a Jew? It is your own people and the chief priests who have handed you over to me. What have you done?"
Jesus replied,
"Mine is not the kingdom of this world. If my kingdom were of this world, my men would have fought to prevent me being surrendered to the Jews. But my kingdom is not this kind."
Pilate said,
"So you are a king then?"
Jesus answered,
"It is you who say, yes, I am a king. I was born for this. I came to the world for this. Bear witness to the truth. And all who are outside of you visit my voice."
Pilate said,
"True. What is that?"
And with that, he went out again to the Jews and said,
"I find no case against him. But according to a custom of yours, I should release one prisoner at the Passover." Would you like me then to release the king of the Jews?
At this he shouted,
not this man, but Barabbas.
Barabbas was afraid. Pilate then had Jesus taken away and scourged. And after this, the soldiers twisted some horns to a crown and put it on his head and dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him and saying,
look, I am going to bring him out to you to let you see that I find no case.
Jesus then came out wearing the crown of thorns and a purple robe. Pilate said,
here is the man.
When they saw him, the chief priests and the guards shouted,
crucify him! Crucify him!
Pilate said,
take him yourself and crucify him. I can find no case against him.
The Jews replied, on a piece of stick, they held it up his mouth. After Jesus said,
is accomplished.
And how it is said in the prophecy.
Kissing in the Jewish home means
I tell you, you are mine. It is to own that person. When the Son kisses the Father, or the Father kisses the Son, is to tell, you are mine. But the kiss that Jesus received, the one kiss that he received the night before he died, the kiss from Judas is a kiss to say, I am not yours. I am not yours. You are not mine. You cut off from the relationship. And Jesus remembered this one kiss which he could not forget. Many friends, today wake up. Because of that one cross, and through that cross, Christ made the best choice. What can, what could the cross mean for us today? We will go throughout this whole service today, wave the cross, looking at the cross, adoring the cross, kissing the cross, and service for God. We have been sending so many messages today, until my phone was stuck, so many messages about Good Friday. I wonder if people know, what is Friday? It's good for all. Do you know that meaning of the cross? The cross is one of the best choices of Christ he made for us. The cross could mean two things. One is to follow Christ wholeheartedly, 100%. To follow Christ, he said, come, carry your cross and follow me. That we are all doing. What does the cross mean? We put just the wood of the cross. It is the wood of the cross that goes to the place sinks before the adoration of the cross tonight. What should this wood mean for us? The wood comes from a tree. There are different types of tree. Trees that we admire, trees that behind our houses, those in the compost. We will find those trees, rain trees, huge trees that can live for years. Trees are symbol of life, living, man, woman. We are all compatible with tree. Tree can tell a lot of stories. Tree can tell abundance of history. Tree is symbol of life. Therefore, life means all of us who are living. Therefore, if Jesus carried the wood of the cross, the wood of the tree means he carried life. He carried all our lives together. He had upon him. And so this is the meaning of the cross. Therefore, the choice of cross for Christ is the best. And because of that, we call it good and we gather here. To remember this choice of Christ. What about last day? When Jesus was standing, people at the time made choices. Instead of Jesus, they chose Caesar. Instead of Jesus, they chose Barabbas. Instead of saying, we want the king, we want the king to live, they chose to crucify him. What about us today? What are our choices today? Can the choices be the best? Are we choosing God? Or choosing God and money? Do we choose our quality time at home? Or we choose to be busy, not wanting to spend time with our loved ones? Are we choosing to live a righteous life? Or my choices to remain as a sinner? Am I choosing friends that are good? Or am I choosing those crimes that are bad things, bad companies, or remain to be enemies? Am I choosing right? Or do I do away with pride and choosing forgiveness today? Am I choosing confession, forgiveness of God, love of God, or choose to remain as I am, where I am, I'll remain there? Jesus' choice on the cross is one of the best, and that choice raised up, raised all of us to the highest. the height of resurrection, which we will see tomorrow. We are all raised up. Our choice must raise something. With Jesus, we must be raised. What are our choices today? We look at the crowd today. Maybe some of us choose to be quiet in washing hands, saying, "This is not my story, this is not my work, this is not my job." Maybe some of us want to be the eldest, choose to be eldest, being quiet to pass judgment. Maybe some of us are hungry, people are looking, not doing anything. Maybe some of us choose to shout, crucify. Maybe some of us don't want anything and we may be out of any drama. Leave me alone. Need our gratitude. What about you? And I ask myself as well, what is my choice today? What is my choice today? Give Jesus the kiss of love, that kiss that Jesus said, "Remember," that can bring me into Jesus and say, "I am yours, you are mine." Or we go on choosing something else that can give Jesus a kiss that he cannot forget. Is that continues to pay him. A kiss that continues to make him sorrowful and sad. For me to serve our parents today,
hari ini dunia bergaung mengenakan kita karena Yesus Tuhan kita telah meninggal dunia. Dia meninggalkan meninggalkan seluruh umat manusia. Mati Tuhan merupakan satu rencana yang dilakukan oleh orang-orang yang tidak bertanggung jawab. Sebenarnya
maupun sama saudara-saudari, keputusan yang kita lakukan kepada
Ada ketidakadilan hukum pada hal ini. Terkait dengan kita, wilayah kita, di rumah kita, ada ketidakadilan hukum dalam kehidupan. Pesan yang kedua, ada penjagaan atas dalam kehidupan. Terkadang kita menjadi indas-indas zaman sekarang, memenjagaan sesama. Pesan yang ketiga, kesediaan Tuhan yang total bagi keselamatan manusia. Untuk kita sekali, mari kita sedia di tengah kehidupan. Siapa yang setia, dia akan berbahagia, kebaikan, dan kesehatan saudara saudara.
Oh. Untuk mereka yang tidak percaya akan Kristus, Thank you. immediately sanctify the meditation of the cross. Mahayogiva, Anunnasi, Sanatrius, as you begin the first of the year, I want you to kneel as you come. will have promises to be brought to you, right?
Thank you. given the instructions. I told him that I was doing the selection. Something came to my mind and I said, I'm going to ask this question and he's done the question to say a few words to you in the light of yesterday, today and tomorrow's service. And I said, liturgy is full of signs and symbols that has a significance in our life, and that significance stems from faith and relationship. So how do we start this again? We started by the first section, which focused on the word. But before the word began, it was a continuation of the arrest of the guard and the presiders coming into possession in silence, reminded us of how we get quiet to Jesus in the garden, and then the wife we kept beginning to open in there. Preparing the disciples who are active in the name of Christ and in the name of the church. In terms of the significance of a priest is not just our sacristus, but the priest acts in persona Christi as in nominate a crazy. In the person of Christ and in the name of the church, the presiders came in and they prostrated while they were waiting for the two trials before heaven and purpose fire. And then the word took us to understand the story of the trial. Right until the night of the gospel, where the most significant thing came up. What kingdom? Whose kingdom? Jesus refuted anything to do with secular power. What is his kingdom? No. What did he say? What was his kingdom? His kingdom is the truth. The reign of God is the truth. That is totally different from secular powers and authority, etc. Now I'm going to go again to the learning course, the normal liturgical tradition whereby we say, tonight the service is in three parts. I will say the service is in four parts because I take out the general intention, which I will call it as the global prayer. And you will understand the significance of the global prayer if you go to the monk's understanding of Lectio Divina, whereby the oratio, the prayer, follows upon the Lectio. But using the monastic mind in order to subdivide, tonight the first section has been to the word of God that helps us, the word of God that enlarges our heart so that we are now able to call upon behalf of the whole world, including the prayer, protect different prayer. Right? Coming from the religious into the secular and into those who are sick and hurt. And so, the word of God for me will be the first part of praying ceremony. The word of God assists us in order to open our hearts, to widen our hearts so that we are now, because the word of God, because the word is crucified, now we are like taking over the sentiment, the essence of Jesus, the word of God, in order to embrace everyone and anyone
First heaven is fire, second heaven is world.
talk in Palestine. All these people. So thank you for this huge champion. And it's been awesome morning, afternoon, and evening for the questions. We have this division of compassionless approach. Thank you, many people. Take note tomorrow. I'm glad that they saw Lisa Alapaska, who goes to classes and loves the Bahasa. That is in English at the end tomorrow, 11 p.m. We have the night service vision. Then on Sunday as usual, Mass, Day, English, 9 a.m. The last local Sabu. I mean, it that saves a lot of funds. This, of course, quite a special that this we have planned for 100 packets. I will get some too. Can you help me to finish up the balance 98 packets? They will come to you. This even support, this is for the mission plan. Thank you. And tonight, we also remember to pray for President Nita Mingati, Subhanallah, Punjab, right? Punjab. And we think of the emails and we pray for that special prayer. So for further info, Candice can contact the board and some stories and pictures and info that you can see, get to know. And just remember to pray the altar like the capital, pray for all prisoners tonight. And I invite you to have a little book of Wasa. We are kind enough to receive it from kind wishes. Thank you for this love. And so we have tea, coffee, and some bread. Please say that each and every one of you, please have a little time.